Hello there guys, and welcome to this week's Cardiocraft. This week we're going to be making Tetris cookie cutters using aluminium drinks cans, a pair of pliers, and a pair of scissors. First up, download and print the Tetris cookie cutter templates from the description below. You'll also need a pair of pliers, a pair of scissors, a permanent marker, a craft knife with a sharp edge, and several aluminium drinks cans. As well as that, you're going to need a long metal ruler, and you're also going to need a stapler for making those longer pieces of metal. First up, use your craft knife to pinch two holes in the end of the drinks can, then use your pair of scissors to cut around the outside of the drinks can. Be careful of the sharp edges. Once you've cut off both ends, use the scissors to cut down the middle to form one long piece of metal. Once done that, turn it inside out and roll it back on itself to help flatten out that curve. Next up, use your permanent marker and your ruler to mark every inch along the edge. Repeat on the other end. Then turn your ruler sideways and join up your marks to make 3-inch long strips. Being careful of the edges, use your craft knife to run along each of your lines you've just drawn. It can be helpful to turn it around at this point here to remove the extra sharp edge. And when you're done, you should have 3 long strips of aluminium 1-inch wide. Once done that, turn the back of themselves, and just like we did with the original can, curl them back to remove that curve which the aluminium can naturally has. Be careful of cats, you never know when they'll come and attack you. Next up, use your pliers to crimp the edges which have been cut with your knife. This will remove any sharp edges, and it will also mean that when you're making your cookies later, you won't have any issues with cutting fingers, and you should get a nice flat line. This slightly thicker edge also helps with making a cut between your Tetris shaped cookies and with the rest of the dough that's left over. Once you've done that, it's time to shape your metal. Using your pliers to help bend your cookie cutters to 90 degrees, that's a right angle, or the corner of a square, bend your metal around and use the template to help you get just the right size there. Once you get to the corners, it can be helpful to use your stapler to join together the different pieces of metal. I find this works really well if you staple it in the middle of the edges, and as you'll see in a minute, I actually end up rebending the metal and reshaping the square slightly so the staples are in the middle of one of the sides. Stapling corners is incredibly hard unless you have a very narrow profile stapler. It's also important to make sure your metal is long enough to cover the shape. Once your metal is in one loop, just rebend your metal so it's in the right shape to match your Tetris piece. As you can see here, I'm pinching the corners as best as possible to try and match that shape. Pliers can be a really helpful way of achieving that, sometimes tricky to make right angle. One useful trick here is to join together two pieces of the aluminium, and that way you have a longer piece for making one of those larger Tetris shapes. Two staples is just about right. And then once you finish, you should have all your different Tetris pieces. As you can see in the bottom piece here, I've added a little corner piece on because I accidentally snapped it. A corner piece here, stapled in place on those two Tetris sides, can help massively with strengthening a Tetris cookie cutter. Well, there you go. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video and it's inspired you to make some cookies of your own. If you've enjoyed it, then please do like the video, subscribe to the channel, and share it with your friends. Any suggestions in the comments below? Thanks very much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.